In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Dear friends, 40 days ago, we celebrated the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now we recall the day on which he was presented in the temple, when he was offered to the Father and shown to his people. As a sign of his coming among us, his mother was purified, as we now come to him for cleansing. In their old age, Simeon and Anna recognized him as their Lord, as we today sing of his glory. In this Eucharist, we celebrate both the joy of his coming and his searching judgment, looking back to the day of his birth and forward to the coming days of his passion. And on the bottom of page 1, we say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remembering God's love for us and the forgiveness offered to all who truly repent, we bring before God anything that weighs on our own conscience, and those things that tarnish the image of God in us. And together we say, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our Maker, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. To wait one announcement about candles after the absolution and before we sing the Gloria. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. If you'd like to remain standing, I'm going to ask our servers if they would be very kind and take these two huge candles, one each, and the other three servers to take one of these little candles. And I'm going to ask you to go around the congregation and to light up everyone's small candle. So, this is a festival of light, and during the Gloria, we're going to light up all your little candles. I know sometimes people really don't like handheld candles. Please don't be forced into this. It's fine just to sit where you are. But if you don't mind having a candle in front of you, it'll be lit up during the Gloria. So we're going to sing the Gloria and pass the light around the church.
Thank you.
This is the collect for Candlemas. Almighty and ever-living God, clothed in majesty, whose beloved Son was this day presented in the temple in substance of our flesh, grant that we may be presented to you with pure and clean hearts by your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And I ask your blessing on all the young people of our church, on all who lead in Junior Church, and on their time together this morning, in Jesus' name. Amen. Please sit down, and if there are any younger members of our church who'd like to make their way to the parish room, they'd be very welcome.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Since the children share flesh and blood, Jesus himself likewise shared the same things, so that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is, the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by the fear of death. For it is clear that he did not come to help angels, but the descendants of Abraham. Therefore, he had to become like his brothers and sisters in every respect, so that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest in the service of God, to make a sacrifice of atonement for the sins of the people. Because he himself was tested by what he suffered, he is able to help those who are being tested. This is the word of the Lord.
Lift up your heads, O gates, be lifted up. for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel. And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed him and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign of all the earth, so that the inner thoughts of men will be ruined, and the sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also the prophet Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage. Then, as a widow, at the age of 84, she never left the temple, but worshipped there with fasting and prayer night and day. At that moment, she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child. All who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the Lord, they returned to the gathering to their own family members. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of the Lord was upon him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Simeon is righteous and devout.
He is almost a temple dweller, the sort of person who longs to be in the house of God. And we have them still today, devout, wonderful people, you very much amongst all of them, who enjoy being in the house of God, enjoy the atmosphere of holy places. Seek them out, not only here, but on their travels. Simeon was somebody who enjoyed being in the temple, enjoyed prayer. And Anna is 84 years old, we're told. And she never left the temple, but worshipped there with fasting and prayer, night and day. Today, as I said, is a festival of light. And when we say that, we don't pretend that everything difficult is simply swept away. Because this particular story is also bittersweet. And I want to explain part of the symbolism of what we'll see in church today. As you walked into the church, you may have noticed that there is a crucifix on a small table in the centre aisle at the back of church this morning. And right behind me, up by the high altar, is our Christmas crib. It's the one day in the year when cross and crib exist in the same space. And that's because Candlemas falls at the midpoint between Christmas and Easter. So we're still filled with the wonder of the manger, but our eyes also are drawn to Holy Week and Easter and the cross. And in terms of the story, Mary is reminded that a sword will pierce her own soul too. So we have the joy of the young child being brought into the temple, but we also have Mary being reminded, as it were, of what's to come in terms of her son on a cross. And for me, that is a playing out of the fact that although we have the light, we also have the challenges of the world around us and our own challenges. They often coexist. The crib and the cross, they remind me that we are called to look triumph and tragedy in the eye. Simeon is touching because when the Christ child is brought in, he says that he realizes that this is the thing that he had always been longing for, the longed for Messiah. And having seen the Christ child, he says, Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace. He's seen the Lord, he's seen the Messiah, he is prepared even to die. I'm sure many of you will have come across a film which is now often repeated on television, entitled The Bucket List, with Jack Nicholson and Morgan Freeman. Their characters meet in a hospital. Together, they construct their bucket list, everything they'd like to do before they die, before colloquially they kick the bucket. And they set off to do it, and part of their ability to do it, of course, is that one of them is phenomenally wealthy, so they can do just about anything they want to do. There is a link here, I think, between the idea of a bucket list, those things in life which you would really love to do, and the story of Simeon. Simeon, somehow, in his spiritual bucket list, has been longing to see the Messiah for all his life. And having seen him, He is now at peace in himself. He is prepared to die. I think today is a really good day to think about the things you'd like to do that would leave you feeling a similar sense of spiritual contentment and fulfillment. And as I say, one thing that, in terms of church life, possibly isn't a very good analogy in relation to the film, is that one of them was phenomenally wealthy, so he could have a dream and execute it very easily. In the spiritual life, of course, wealth has absolutely nothing to do with it, and I'm not talking about simply jetting around the world or climbing the highest mountain if that's what you'd like to do. I'm thinking about things that actually don't involve money whatsoever. It might be a regret from the past. It might be somebody that you haven't allowed yourself to forgive. It might be something where you'd like to make amends. It might be a relationship you'd like to patch up. It might even be a little bit of your life that you'd like to reflect on more deeply, that you haven't had a chance to think about at the depth you'd like to. Those are the sorts of things I'm thinking about in terms of the spiritual life. Those things that, if we did them, our hearts would be more at peace. That's the sort of thing I'm thinking about. The other thing I'd like to remind you of is that bringing light into the world has all sorts of different forms. Recently, Lisa Ray from our congregation came to the parish council. We weren't talking directly about this, but Lisa Ray was reminding us to be mindful of one another as the dark, cold days of January are treacherous for the mental health of many people. It's really good at this cold and sometimes dark time of year to have a festival of light, Candlemas, in the midst of these dark days. That's not only for the physical light of the candles, but for the spiritual light that they signify. If you'd like another Bible story to accompany the presentation of Christ in the temple, think of the Transfiguration, when Christ on Mount Ebal glows with interior light. If you want to lift your spirits, remember that light. Remember that we can connect with it in prayer and in worship. And remember the light and goodness that is in you, often seen more clearly by others than by you yourself. The goodness in you, that light, is fed, is enhanced by the light of Christ. If you feel these dark days dragging you down, please remember the light in you. Please put your trust in the light of Christ, the light which Simeon and Anna saw. That light is a light to lighten the Gentiles, and a light for each one of us. Amen.
Creator of heaven and earth, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only
conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Would you please sit for our Mass?
Almighty God, as we celebrate the feast of Candlemas this week, we give thanks to your Son, Jesus, who is the light of the world, and for your call to us to share in that light. We pray that our church may be a light in the community, a beacon to all those who live in any kind of darkness, and a mirror of God's love. Thanksgiving, and show the light of your presence in our daily lives. Let us pray for God's church throughout the world. O Lord, who in days gone by revealed the glory of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to your faithful servants, Simeon and Anna, grant that we in this time may recognize your presence in the world, and like them, sing out your praises and witness to your great redeeming love. We pray for Sarah, Bishop of London, and Joanne, Bishop of Stepney, and for all the parishes in the Hackney Deanery. We pray especially for Andrew and Charlotte, and for all who worship and serve here in St. John of Jerusalem. May God strengthen your church in the service of Christ, that those who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Let us pray for the world, with all its beauty and all its suffering. God, we thank you for the wondrous world you have created. Forgive us when we fail to cherish and care for it as we should, or when we treat one another without love or respect. Let us remember those parts of the world where there is suffering and conflict, and pray that God's love and justice may overcome hatred. We especially think of Ukraine and Russia, and pray for a just end to the terrible war. We also pray for the peoples of Afghanistan, especially for all the brave women who are struggling to maintain their basic human rights. Let us remember all refugees, asylum seekers, and displaced people, and pray that our prosperous world may be more compassionate and caring for those who are persecuted and traumatized. O God, bless and guide Charles our King, give wisdom to all in authority, and direct this and every nation in the ways of justice and peace, that we may all honour one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy. Let us pray for our local communities, families and friends. O Lord, we ask for your blessing on all those who live and work in Hackney. We pray for the council and all community leaders, that they may act for the good and prosperity of the whole community. We pray for those who work to support support the vulnerable and sick within the community, and for all those who work with children and young people. We pray especially at this challenging time for all who work in the NHS and the community care services. Give them strength to cope with the terrible stresses they deal with day to day. And pray that a fair and just solution may be found to the current industrial impacts. Lord, we ask your blessing on our own families and friends, both those we see regularly and those who live far away, but who are always in our hearts. But God, give grace to our families and friends and to all our neighbours, that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Let us pray for those in any kind of need or distress. O Lord, we bring before you anyone we know who is sick in mind or body, anyone who is in pain or despair. We pray for the hungry, the homeless, the destitute, and anyone who feels isolated or unloved. We especially pray for those known to this parish who are in special need of love and support at this time. O Lord, bring comfort to those who suffer, for whatever reason, and grant that each of us may find ways in our own lives to bring support and love to those around us. God, comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them to the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
At the end of the week where we have remembered the Holocaust, let us remember before God all those who suffered and died at that terrible event. And pray for the souls of all those who have died and continue to die as a result of hatred and persecution. Finally, let us remember all those who are no longer with us, but whom we have loved and who have been a beacon of light in our lives. Let us give thanks for their lives and grant that one day we may all be reunited in God's redeeming love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Would you please stand where possible? We are the body of Christ in one spirit. We were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We offer one another a sign of God's peace.
Thank you.
And today I would like to bless the candles of the church for the use and during the year ahead. Lord God, the springing source of everlasting light, bless these candles and pour into the hearts of your faithful people the brilliance of your eternal splendor, that we who by these kindling flames light up this temple to your glory may have the darkness of our souls dispelled and so be counted worthy to stand before you in that eternal city where you live and reign, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Our offertory prayers are on page 8 of the service book. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made, become for us the bread of life. Blessed be our Lord forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. Come for us, the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. We're to use Eucharistic credit E today, which you can find in the back of the service booklet on page 23. The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right,
you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son Jesus Christ to be our Savior. His dying and rising have set us free from sin and death, and so we gladly thank you with saints and angels, praising you and saying,
Great is the mystery of faith.
comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people. Gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with John the Baptist and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
after the service there are always people to pray with you or speak with you and offer prayers for healing in this summer chapel behind where Victoria plays the organ. If you'd like that, please make your way there after the service. Our youth group meets today, so any of our younger members of the church who would like to spend some time together over pizza, please make your way to the rectory after the service. I just wanted you to know that yesterday evening there was a wonderful night shelter concert here, and of course not all of us can go to everything, so just to let you know that it was a fabulous concert, and the church was absolutely heaving with people, and our building in that sense is a great resource to the neighbourhood. Last year they managed to raise about £10,000 in a single concert, and I wouldn't be at all surprised if they'd done the same last night. But in a way, it's a way of saying thank you to you, because without all of you, this place wouldn't exist at all, and we are a resource for the neighbourhood, and it was lovely to see it used for such a good purpose yesterday for the Hackney Night Shelter. Evening prayer is here today at 4 p.m. You'd be really welcome. We're continuing to consult about plans at the back. If you felt like writing any suggestions or comments, they can be positive, they can be negative, they can be things that we might not have thought about, please don't hesitate to write them down and put them in the box at the back. We're continuing to ask people about fuel bills and whether people in our midst are struggling, as many are. If you are, please don't hesitate to mention it to myself or our church wardens or Shana or Doug, and we would love to help you. People have been very generous to us, and we want to get that money away. On Tuesday this week, there is a lovely event which I'd like to invite you to. Every so often, there's an event called Stepney at Prayer, which is an evening service arranged by the Bishop of Stepney. Last time it was at Christ Church Spitalfields, and this time it will be here with us. And it's on Tuesday of this coming week. It's 7 p.m. and the doors open at 6:30. We've been asked to put on a service of compline, which is a lovely reflective service. It's the last office of the monastic day. It's night prayer. And some lovely music has been arranged and thought about, and it's a lovely prayerful service. If you're free, on 7 p.m. on Tuesday. Very kindly, Basil and Maria are going to look after some tea and coffee. I just wondered if there were two people who would be willing to be on the draw that evening, just as stewards. There's nothing much to do. It's literally one service booklet and being a smiley, welcoming presence on the door, and I just wondered if there were two people who knew they were going to be here on Tuesday at 7 who would be willing to be stewards on Tuesday evening. Just wondered if there were one here. Thank you, Phil and Gatry, that would be perfect. If you didn't mind coming in about 6:20, if that's not too early, 6:20 on Tuesday, that would be a huge help. There is very exciting church cleaning on Saturday of this coming week. Everybody welcome, and I'll leave you to read all the other notices and the morning, evening prayer times. Are there any other notices that people would like to give out that I might have forgotten? I just wanted to say how lovely it is to see Henrietta, to see Henrietta here on this. And I wonder whether we could all give her a round of applause to welcome her back to church. Tea and coffee afterwards, you'd be really welcome. And our final hymn is number 145. Love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ.